Good day, dear children. Hope you all are keeping in good health by the grace of God and concentrating on your studies. Today we will be studying Geography, Chapter 8, Economy and Occupations. What is an economy? An economy encompasses all activity related to production, consumption and trade of goods and services in an area. It applies to everyone from individuals to entities such as corporations and governments. An economy of a country depends on the economic activities carried out in the country. We have three types of economic activities. You have studied this in Standard 8. They are primary activities, secondary activities and tertiary activities. We will just have a small recap of what these activities are. Now in primary activities, you will find hunting, agriculture, fishing, forestry, mining, etc. So these are related to extraction and production of raw materials. With the help of these primary activities, secondary activities are made, that is, the raw material is transformed to finished product. This comes in secondary activity. So we have the industries in this category. Example, manufacturing steel into cars or textiles to clothing, etc. Then to help us too, we have one more activity, that is the tertiary activity. In this, services we find travel, education, administration, business consultancy, hospitals, that is, they are related to providing services. Let's study the economic activities of Brazil and India. In these pie charts, you can see the contribution of each sector in the GDP of respective countries and the percentage of population engaged in various sectors or in various activities. So we will read the pie charts carefully and answer the given questions. Before that, let us understand what is GDP. GDP means gross domestic product. It means the total value of goods and services that are produced in a country. Now in here you can see this. These are known as pie charts. The left ones, they denote Brazil, and these ones, they denote India. Then this two, they denote the contribution of sectors in GDP, and these two, they denote the percentage of population engaged in various sectors of Brazil and India respectively. Then blue color denotes the primary sector or the primary activities. Orange color denotes the secondary activities and the gray color denotes the tertiary activities. Now here in this picture or in this pie chart, you can see that only 5.5% of contribution is from the primary activities in GDP. Then 27.5% contribution is from the secondary sectors in GDP, and here in this picture you can see 67% of contribution is from the tertiary sectors in GDP, whereas of India the tertiary sector contributes 57%, primary sector contributes 26% and the secondary sector contributes 26% and the primary sector contributes 17%. Now in this picture, in this pie chart, you can see the percentage of population that is engaged in various sectors. So in Brazil, 10% of the population, that is of the total population, is engaged in primary activities, 19% is engaged in secondary activities, and 71% population is engaged in tertiary activities, whereas in India 48.8% population is engaged in primary activities, 24.3% population is engaged in secondary activities, and 26.9% population is engaged in tertiary activities. Now, based on these pie charts, let us answer the questions that are given. Which country has a higher percentage of population engaged in primary activities? Now, this is the population engaged in primary activities. Now, which is the country which has the highest population? These are the primary activities shown in blue color. So, it is India. Next question. In which country is the contribution of tertiary sector greater in GDP? Now, this is the contribution of GDP. Then, in which country the contribution of tertiary sector is greater? This is the contribution of tertiary sector. Brazil is 67%, India is 57%. So, Brazil is having more contribution in the tertiary sector in GDP. In which country is the share of secondary activities more in GDP? Now see, this is the contribution in GDP. These are the secondary activities. So which country is having more share? It is Brazil. Then can we say that Brazil is an agrarian economy like India? Give reasons. Now see, as I told you all in while recapitulating the primary activities, secondary activities and tertiary activities, that agriculture is included in primary activity. Now can we say that Brazil is an agrarian, it has an agrarian economy like India? No, because nearly 71% of the population of Brazil is engaged in tertiary sector and only 10% of the population is engaged in primary sector. And over here also, more contribution in GDP is from the tertiary sector, that is 67%. So this shows that it has strong and a rapid growing service sector. So we cannot say that Brazil has an agrarian economy like India. Brazil has a strong and rapidly growing service sector. It is one of the world's giants of mining, agriculture and manufacturing. On the other hand, India is still dependent on agriculture. Although the service sector is also increasing in India, but yet it's dependent on agriculture. Indian and Brazilian economies are mixed economies. They are developing economies, as these countries are developing countries. And so the per capita income of these countries is very less compared to the developed countries. Now what is per capita income? It means the per person income. Now we are going to see the table, that is the per person's income. What we saw before in the pie chart, that was the total national income, and in this table you can see the per capita income from 1960 to 2016, and it is in US dollars. And this income, there is a comparison between Brazil, India and USA. Now Brazil and India, these are developing countries, but USA is a developed country. So you will notice that in all these 4 years which are mentioned, the per capita income of USA was always higher. And compared to India, the per capita income of Brazil was high. Now let's see what was the reason for US to have this high per capita income. First is, USA is a developed country. Second, the population of this country is well educated. Third, it has the strength of many patents in modern technology and mechanical strength. But Brazil and India, they are still progressing. They are on the path of progress in the field of industrialization, modern technology and education. It is increasing at a fast rate. We saw that total national income of India is more, but the per capita income of Brazil is more. Actually, India's per capita income should be more, but because of massive population of India, Brazil has more per capita income due to the lesser population. We will now study the occupations in Brazil. First is agriculture. Now here in this map you can see which are the different crops that are grown in Brazil. Coffee, rice, corn, it is also known as maize, sugarcane, cocoa, rubber, and some fruits like bananas, oranges, and even soya bean, another crop has been grown over here. Agriculture is the main occupation in Brazil. And in Brazil, people who live in the Brazilian highlands, these are the Brazilian highlands, and these are the coastal areas. So people, those who live in the coastal areas and in the Brazilian highland, for them agriculture is the main occupation. Then we find variety in the crops in Brazil. It is because of the favorable climate and because of the topography. Topography means the physical features. Then cereal crops like rice and maize, they are the main crops, and we find that this crops, rice and maize, they are grown in the central part and in the coastal part. Rice is grown in the coastal part. See, this is the symbol for rice and this is the symbol for maize. So rice is grown in the coastal part and maize is grown in the central part of Brazil. Apart from these main crops, we also find some cash crops or commercial crops like coffee, cocoa, rubber, soybean, and sugarcane. We all know that Brazil is famous for coffee and it exports coffee to various parts of the world. But along with coffee, Brazil also exports soybean on a large scale. And major coffee growing states are Minas Gerais and Sao Paulo. Then we also find fruits like bananas, pineapples, oranges, and other citrus fruits are grown in Brazil. Next, we will study about animal husbandry. In savanna grasslands in the southern part of Brazil, we find cattle, sheep, and goat are rare. See, this is the symbol for animal husbandry. You can see over here, these are the savanna grasslands. So cattle have been reared in the savanna grasslands as well as in the southern part of Brazil. And we find meat and dairy products are produced on a larger scale in Brazil. Next important occupation is mining. So the minerals that are found in Brazil are iron ore, manganese, nickel, copper, bauxite, tungsten, diamonds, etc. See, these are the symbols for mining, and you can see over here in this map that mining is developed in the highland regions. These are the highland regions and in the eastern part of Brazil. Although mining is developed in these parts, yet there are some factors that have led to limitations in mining in Brazil and in the interior parts. Let's see which are those factors. First is inaccessibility, that is, there is no access to reach out to these minerals. Second is, people do not have proper knowledge about the reserves of these resources, that is, reserves of these minerals. And third is dense forests. Because of the dense forests, people are not able to get access to this to the different mineral reserves which have been there in Brazil. Next occupation what we will study about is fishing. Brazil, it has a coastline of 7,400 kilometers. Marine fishing is developed in Brazil. This is the coastline of Brazil, and this is the symbol for fisheries, and you can see that it denotes that the marine fishing is developed over here. This is the North Atlantic Ocean and this is the South Atlantic Ocean. These are the ocean currents. And the South Atlantic Ocean is considered to be excellent for fishing, and the reason is the meeting of the warm Brazil current and the cold Falkland current. So because of the confluence of the warm Brazil current and the cold Falkland current, the South Atlantic Ocean is considered to be excellent ground for fishing. Then fishing is one of the traditional occupation in Brazil, and the fishermen have been using the old techniques and equipments for fishing, but nowadays they also make use of large vessels. The fishes that are found in Brazil are swordfish, shrimp, lobsters and sardines. Inland fishing is not much developed in Brazil, though there are large number of rivers in Brazil, but this inland fishing or the freshwater fishing is not much developed. Over here you can see there are many rivers in the northern part of Brazil, but yet this inland fishing or freshwater fishing is not developed. The reason is because of the physiography as well as the dense forests of Brazil, which makes the regions inaccessible. And apart from this, the other main reason is the rivers, they flow with great speed and it makes difficult for fishing. We will now study about industries in Brazil. The major industries in Brazil are iron and steel production, automobile assembly, petroleum processing, chemicals production, cement making, technologically based industries, etc. Now these are some of the major industries, but apart from these industries we also have some other industries like traditional industries, food processing industries, sugar industries, cotton textile, silk and woolen industries, etc. Now let's see about the distribution of these industries. Many large scale industries, they are concentrated in the southern and the southeastern region in Brazil. The northeast is traditionally the poorest part of Brazil, but government has taken an initiative in new investment plans to promote industrial growth in this region as well. Occupations in India: agriculture,
Agriculture, it is one of the traditional occupations, and nearly 60% of the land of India is under cultivation, and most of the agriculture is of subsistence nature. Subsistence means for one's own use. Then agriculture, it contributes in the gross that is the contribution of agriculture in gross domestic product is high, and compared to Brazil, the percentage of population that is engaged in agriculture is also high. Now, what are the factors that promote agriculture? They are the fertile soils, the extensive plains, long growing seasons, variety in climate. These are all the factors which are promoting agriculture. Some of the main food crops that are grown in India are rice, wheat, sorghum, millets, maize, etc. Apart from these main food crops, we also have some cash crops which are grown in India. Cash crops means the commercial crops, and they are tea, coffee, cotton, sugarcane, rubber, jute, etc. And along with these crops, we also have variety of spices, fruits and vegetables which are cultivated in India. Next occupation is fishing. India has a coastline of 7,500 kilometers, and fishing plays an important role in the economy of India. India is considered to be the largest producers of fish, both marine and inland fishing. Now, we saw in Brazil that marine fishing is developed whereas inland fishing is not developed. But in India, both marine and inland fishing are developed. This fishing, it provides foodstuff and diet. It also generates employment. It raises the nutritional level and it helps in earning foreign exchange. Fish, it is an important diet of the people who live in the states of Maharashtra, Goa, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal and Odisha. Now, this fishing, that is marine fishing, it accounts nearly 40% of the total annual production of fish. That is, from whatever income has been generated from fishing, from that 40% has been contributed from marine fishing. And some of the coastal waters to which this marine fishing is confined is in the west from Kutch. This is the Kutch coast over here. Then the Malabar coast in the west, to the Coromandel in the east. This is the Coromandel coast. So to this the marine fishing has been confined to. Then in the Arabian Sea we find sardines, mackerel, Bombay duck, prawns. Whereas in Bay of Bengal we find fishes like horse mackerel, pluppets and silver bellies. Freshwater fishing, or else it is also said to be inland fishing, it accounts nearly 60% of the total annual production of fish. The marine fishing, it accounts to 40%, and freshwater fishing, it accounts to 60%. And mainly this freshwater fishing has been carried in rivers, canals, irrigation channels, tanks, ponds, lakes, etc. And the fishes which are found over there are silver bellies, carp, which is also known as chopra. These are the major freshwater varieties of fish. Mining. Many minerals have been found in the Chota Nagpur Plateau. So, Chota Nagpur Plateau is also known as storehouse of variety of minerals, and mining is developed on a large scale in this Chota Nagpur plateau. Coal. Coal is mined in Korba in Chhattisgarh and in eastern Maharashtra. Mineral oil wells. We find mineral oil wells in Digboi in Assam, Mumbai High in the Arabian Sea near Mumbai in Maharashtra, Kalol and Koyali in Gujarat. Then reserves of mineral oil and natural gas have been found at the mouth of river Godavari as well. Stones. We find marble in Rajasthan and Kadapa in Andhra Pradesh. Let us study about the industries in India. These are the logos of various industries in India. The first logo, this ONGC, it is Oil and Natural Gas Corporation Limited, which means ONGC. It is the India's largest oil and gas exploration and production company. The next logo, this one, is Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, RINL, and it is also known as Vizag Steel. It is a public steel producer. This logo, RA, it is of milk industry. The fourth one, CLW, it is one of the largest locomotive manufacturers in the world. The fourth one, this one, Maharashtra Agro Industries Development Corporation Limited, MAIDC. It makes available to the farmers of Maharashtra standard quality seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, agro engineering implements and animal feed to the extent required and at the time of requirement and at competitive rates. This logo is of Khadi and Village Industries Commission, KVIC. It is a body which has been formed by the Government of India and it is related to Khadi and Village Industries within India. This logo is Central Silk Board, CSB. It deals with silk production. And the last logo, RCF, it means Rashtriya Chemicals and Fertilizers Limited. It is one of the leading producers of fertilizers in India. Now, which raw materials are used by these industries? So the agro-based industries like the Maharashtra Agro Industries Development, this and Khadi Village Industries Commission, they make use of raw materials like seeds. Then the raw materials required for the production of pesticides and fertilizers, cotton, silk and wool. Then the animal product based industries, that is RA and Central Silk Board, they make use of, RA makes use of milk and this CSB makes use of silk. Then the minerals and metal based industries, that is ONGC, then Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, and then the Chittaranjan Locomotive Works. So ONGC, it makes use of raw material, that is crude oil and natural gas. Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, they make use of steel, and Chittaranjan Locomotive Works make use of raw materials like iron and steel and various metals. And another industry related to minerals and metals is the Rashtriya Chemicals and Fertilizers Limited. It makes use of coal and limestone. Metallurgical industries. Jharkhand, Orissa, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu.
This states they have most of the reserves of metallic minerals. Most of the metallurgical industries, they are concentrated in the northeastern part of the peninsula. Availability of coal and refractory minerals. Power from Damodar Valley Corporation, number of thermal power projects, they have supported these metallurgical industries in this region. Then in Rajasthan, industries like copper, lead, zinc are developed. Then steel, manganese and aluminium based industries. These industries are found in Karnataka. And aluminium based industries are concentrated in Tamil Nadu. Agro-based industries. Agro-based industries like cotton, jute and sugar. These industries are concentrated in the raw material producing areas. So we find sugar industries in Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh. Then we find jute industry is developed in West Bengal. Then forest based industries like paper, plywood, matches, resins, lac, etc. These industries are located near forests in many states. Then the coir and copra and fish canning industries. We find these industries mostly in the coastal regions, especially in Kerala. Now what is copra? Copra means dried coconut kernels from which oil is obtained. Now we will study about the oil refining industries. Many times this oil refining industries are located near the coastal petroleum producing areas. So we find these industries at Koyali, Digboi, Noonmati and Bongaigaon. So these refineries are located near the coastal petroleum producing areas. But the refineries like Mathura and Barauni refineries, they are located in the interior parts, that is away from the coastal oil producing areas. Cement industries. Cement industries, they are mainly located near the raw material producing areas. Salt industries we find in Gujarat, Rajasthan and Tamil Nadu. Then apart from these industries, that is based on agriculture, metals, oil refineries, cement and salt, there are some other industries like mechanical engineering industries, chemical industries, automobile industries, fertilizer producing industries, consumer industries, and these all industries are distributed all over the country. And they are mainly concentrated near the big towns and cities. We shall study about trade of India and Brazil. This table, it shows the export, import and balance of trade in, and the value is in US dollars. So it shows the balance of trade, that is the export, import and balance of trade of India and Brazil. It shows the exports and imports in the year 2009-10, 10-11, 2011-12 and 12-13. Okay, so by reading this table we have to answer the questions. But before that, what is balance of trade? The difference between the import and export values of a country in a particular period is known as balance of trade. So the difference, that is between the import and the export value of a particular country in a particular period is known as balance of trade. Now there are three types of balance of trades. They are unfavorable balance of trade, favorable balance of trade and balanced trade.
Now, what is unfavorable balance of trade? It means that such type occurs when the value of imports is more than the value of exports. Now, see over here in this table, you can see in the year 2009-10, the exports were 1,78,751.4 US dollars, whereas the imports were 2,88,372.9 US dollars. So here the value of imports was more than the value of exports. That means it was unfavorable balance of trade. Now next is favorable balance of trade. Now what is favorable balance of trade? Such type occurs when the value of exports is more than the value of imports. Now look over here. Here the export value is 1,52,994.7 US dollars, whereas the value of exports is 1,27,647.3 US dollars. So here the export value is more. So when the export value is more, that type of trade is said to be favorable balance of trade. When the import value is more, that type of trade is said to be unfavorable balance of trade. So now what is balance trade? So this balance trade occurs when the value of exports and imports is almost the same. Now the third question given to us is, in which country export exceeds import in all the years? Now see, these are the export values of India and these are the export values of Brazil. And these are the import values of India and these are the import value of Brazil. Now looking at this table, we have to find which country's export exceeds import in all the years. So the answer is Brazil. Next question, Brazil's balance of trade belong to which type? So what do you think? The export value is always greater. So it is favorable balance of trade. Then India's balance of trade belong to which type? India's imports is always greater than exports. So it is unfavorable balance of trade. We will now do a comparative study of India and Brazil with reference to import, export, trading partners and contribution of trade in GDP. Now, this is about India and this is about Brazil. So, what all things does India import? India imports petroleum, machines, pearls, precious stones, gold, silver, paper and medicines. Whereas Brazil imports machinery, chemical products, fertilizers, wheat, heavy vehicles, mineral oil, lubricants, etc. Now India exports tea, coffee, spices, leather and leather goods, iron ore, cotton, silk textiles, mangoes, etc. Brazil, it exports iron ore, coffee, cocoa, soybean, sugar, tobacco, oranges, bananas, etc. Now, which are the trading partners of India? That is, India has trade relations with which other countries? It is UK, USA, Germany, Japan, China, Russia. And Brazil, it has trading partners. That is, the trading partners of Brazil are Germany, USA, Canada, Argentina, Saudi Arabia and India. Now trade contributes. What is the contribution of trade in GDP? So in India, the contribution of trade in GDP in the year 2012 was 40%, whereas that of Brazil in the year 2012 was 25%. Let's study about the contribution of trade in GDP. The blue color line, it shows
the trade of Brazil, and the pink color line shows trade of India. So here you can see these are the years and this is the percentage of GDP. Okay, so in the year 2010, India's contribution of trade in GDP, this is year 2010, pink one is of India, so its contribution was 50%. Then till the year 1990, the contribution in GDP by India was lesser than that of Brazil. And after 1990 to 2010, the GDP of India kept on increasing continuously. However, after 2010 to 2016, India's contribution of trade in GDP has decreased by 10%. See, now over here in 2010, the GDP was 50%, but in 2016, it came back to 40%, so it has fallen by, or it has reduced by 10%. Similarly, nowadays also you happen to hear in the news or read in, you might have even read in the newspaper that the GDP rate of India has fallen down, it has gone to negative. Now let's study about BRICS and about Indo-Brazil ties. What is BRICS? BRICS is the acronym which is coined for an association of five major emerging national economies. Now what does BRICS stand for? B stands for Brazil, R stands for Russia, I stands for India, C stands for China, and S stands for South Africa. Second question, when was it established? It was established in June 2006. Now what are the objectives of this bloc? So mutual economic assistance, increase in the trade between the member countries and cooperation, these are the main objectives of this bloc. So which are the member countries? Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa, these are the member countries. So the objective to form this BRICS was provide mutual economic assistance as well as to increase the trade between these member countries as well as to cooperate among each other. Next question, the countries of which continent are not a member of this bloc? So the countries of continent of North America, Europe, Australia and Antarctica are not a member of this bloc. In which continents do the member countries lie? So the member countries, they lie in the continents of South America, Asia and Africa. Let's study about the comparative study of India and Brazil with reference to foreign investments. And the points that we will study about are level of investment and sectors of investment. Indian companies, they have invested at a higher level in Brazil, whereas compared to India, Brazilian companies' investment in India is low. Then which are the sectors of investment, that is in which sectors India has invested in Brazil? It is IT, that is information technology, pharmaceuticals, energy, agro-business, mining, engineering and auto sectors. And Brazil has invested in India in IT, mining, energy, biofuels and footwear. Now students, many times you all have heard that coffee is the major exporter of Brazil. But do you know that Brazil has been the largest producer of coffee for the last 150 years? But the plant, that is the coffee plant, it belongs originally to Ethiopia. It was first brought to Brazil by some French settlers who established in the state of Pará in the early 18th century. And coffee farms, they are also called as fazendas.
then the taxes what we pay, usually if we take a bill of anything, there it is mentioned tax or GST. When we go to DMart or Big Bazaar, there also regarding GST it is 2% or 9% or 18%, like that. So these taxes, they are important. What are these all, GST and all? They are taxes. Taxes are important of the economy and trade of any country. India has now switched to the GST, that is goods and service tax, and it aims towards one tax all over the country on various commodities and services. And Brazil too has adopted this system from the year 1984. Like India, Brazil also has various slabs for GST. Students, I hope you have understood this lesson. Your homework is, you have to read this graph, and based on this graph you have to answer these questions which are given. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.